NBC News is reporting that veteran Today Show anchor Matt Lauer has been fired for inappropriate sexual behavior in the workplace. This is the latest high-profile media figure to be terminated amid sexual allegations. I mean, it doesn't actually get bigger in our business than Matt Lauer, I think it's fair to say. He has been such a staple of morning news and morning TV throughout most of our lives. CNN senior media correspondent and host of Reliable Sources, Brian Stelter, joins us with the breaking details. Brian, before you give us what you've learned, let's watch what Savannah Guthrie, his co-host, said to America this morning.
And good morning, everybody. Welcome to Today. And Hoda's here with me this morning because this is a sad morning here at Today and at NBC News. Just moments ago, NBC News Chairman Andy Lack sent the following note to our organization. Dear colleagues, on Monday night, we received a detailed complaint from a colleague about inappropriate sexual behavior in the workplace by Matt Lauer. It represented, after serious review, a clear violation of our company's standards. As a result, we have decided to terminate his employment. While it is the first complaint about his behavior in the over 20 years he has been at NBC News, we were also presented with reason to believe this may not have been an isolated incident. Our highest priority is to create a workplace environment where everyone feels safe and protected, and to ensure that any actions that run counter to our core values are met with consequences, no matter who the offender. We are deeply saddened by this turn of events, but we will face it together as a news organization and do it in as transparent a manner as we can. That is the statement from our chairman, Andy Lack. And
all right, let's bring in Brian Stelter. Brian, look, we're shocked. I mean, we're just shocked to hear that Matt Lauer has been terminated this morning.
Matt Lauer has been the cornerstone of the Today Show for 25 years. He is a figure who is revered in the television business, an icon of television news. But let's face what's going on here a little bit underneath the surface. For several weeks, the New York Times has been working on an investigation into Lauer and into alleged sexual misconduct. It's the kind of story, Allison, Chris, we may have known about. I certainly knew. There were rumors in our business about this story.
But it wasn't a little different than all of the stuff that we've heard about Charlie Rose and Harvey Weinstein and Roger Ailes. Wasn't this in a different category or no?
Well, I want to be clear. I don't know the details of what the New York Times may or may not have. This story has not been published by the Times, but it was well known within NBC that there was this reporting going on, that women were being contacted, that women were being interviewed. I don't know if the Times has people on the record or not. All of that remains to be seen. But Jodi Kantor, who worked on the Harvey Weinstein story, was one of the reporters doing this pursuit, so that's why this was buzzed about in the business. Now, more importantly, NBC says a woman came forward on the record on Monday night with an allegation against Lauer, and that is what triggered this move overnight. Savannah Guthrie said she was just informed overnight, but certainly there was talk about this inside NBC that maybe there was embarrassing information about to come out about Matt Lauer, and we've seen the companies, whether it's on the West Coast, that companies like Amazon, or on the East Coast, companies like CBS, taking a very serious, responding very seriously when there are allegations that go public. Charlie Rose being the most recent example last week.
All right, look, there's a couple of tough points that we have to make about this story. But first, the president has already weighed in on it. And he says, wow, Matt Lauer just fired from NBC for inappropriate sexual behavior in the workplace, but when will the top executives at NBC and Comcast be fired for putting out so much fake news? Check out Andy Lack's past.
You need to be quiet.
This is not helpful to us in terms of examining what this means for how women are treated in the workplace. And I think it's probably a little bit obvious in terms of what the president's avoiding. There are reasons that he's avoiding it because it touches on his own behavior. Right. However, Allison has been outspoken on this as someone who was victimized by it and wants to see change about it. I have been fairly consistent in saying you got to get men involved in this conversation because they're the ones who cut the deals. They're the ones who allow NDAs. They're the ones who are doing the inappropriate behavior.
Ladies,
that said,
take too long to say anything.
What is happening with the pendulum of change right now?
For someone else
you have sexual assault and gross misconduct by any definition that we saw with different people in Hollywood, and they're gone.
Molested.
You saw it with media figures, and it's gone. Then,
or whatever,
in the hunt
because they
for
don't speak
new
up in the
and more, we see a changing scale. Now, we see the biggest name, the best anchor in the history of morning television on the male
like
side,
me?
To be sure,
is gone, and I don't know why.
Out there.
I don't know what the one allegation is. I don't know what they say. I see that NBC gave themselves cover in that statement, saying that it's the first complaint they've had in 20 years.
But
there may have been more. That's corporate cover going on there.
Well,
there may have been more because the New York Times clearly has more information.
But they're saying it that way because they have potential exposure in terms of what they knew. This gets to be legal, not just cultural.
Yes.
So my question becomes, how do you appraise these things? If everybody's getting the same penalty on the media side, not the political side, we don't see anything happening on the political side. There's a totally double standard. But how is he the same as a Weinstein with what we know right now? That's
what I'm saying. And here's the deal. We don't have enough information.
That's right. We don't have enough information right now.
But I think that it is safe to assume that you do not terminate the biggest broadcaster in TV news for one idle complaint.
Now, they suggest
I think that there may have been more.
I'm just saying, we've gotten from Stark, everybody's known this for years, the guy's a predator and this and that, to this.
Well, look, we just don't know yet. But to your point, that we knew that the New York Times was working on something, and this is, tell me if I'm wrong, the first time the network is getting out ahead of it, before
I think that's right. I think that's right. This was Monday night. The network says it received a complaint. Wednesday morning, early Wednesday morning, staffers were told Matt Lauer is out. It is a stunning move by NBC.
Right.
And it begs the question about what else the network knows that we don't know. Suffice to say, Matt Lauer, as you said, Chris, he has been the bedrock of the Today Show, you said, I think, the best morning anchor.
Oh, that's my opinion.
Male morning anchor.
My opinion also.
You know,
no offense.
Listen, high praise from him for me. He has always been a mentor in terms of how to do the job on air.
Yeah.
Obviously, his behavior off air matters much more than what he does on air. All I'm saying is this. This culture changes because it changes at the top. Firing talent is hard financially. It is not hard from a management position. Changing your culture, what you allow to be settled, how you deal with it when it happens in the workplace, who makes those decisions, that's culture. That's corporate. That's hard. We don't see that. We see them getting rid of Lauer, getting rid of Charlie Rose. We don't see culture change.
Yeah, but anybody who doubted that we're on a tipping point, I think today
now. And by the way, Lauer has not even commented yet. I'm trying to get comment from him. Let's see what he says about this.
Okay, Brian, please be on standby for us for the rest of the morning.
All right, so big day, period. Certainly we have to start with what's going on in our government. Mm-hmm. President Trump, he had a big positive day in terms of getting a tax bill through. Now it goes to the floor.